actually changing? Then use the plus sign and select the second cell. Use the plus sign. Use the second, third cell and plus and both. So the color of the cell is going to change in this case. So all the cells will have the different different colors. Cell borders will be. Cell borders will have the different colors. So likewise, we can use the plus sign, and then press enter. So if you use the plus command, then which functions we have used for that purpose? Suppose go back to the cell and go to the function. So here in the function bar, we can get the information about which formula we have used. Similarly, we can use the minus sign also. So I want to find out the minus sign. 40 minus 20. So likewise, we can use the minus sign. If you want to use the more operations, then in that case, use the bracket. Suppose that I want to make the summation of our first two number, and then from that, we want to subtract the third and fourth number. Use the bracket. Select the first number, then plus, second number, close the bracket, then minus, open the bracket, third number and addition of the fourth number. So we have to use the properly the brackets in the Excel. If you do not use the brackets properly, then there should be some jumbling will be there. So for that purpose, we have to use this brackets when we are using the function. Like then we can use the division also. So division. So for that purpose, 40 divided by this line is available. Inclined line, so that is will be called as the division divided by some number. Then we can use it division. We can also find out the product of the two number. Its multiplication equal to 14. Use this multiplication sign and then the first number. So for this purpose, we can. By using this function, we can find out the product. Then, sometime we have to use the power function, means square or cube. So I want to find out what is the square of this 20. So use the power function, shift and 6. So the keyword is this power function is this symbol is available near to the keyboard. Shift, press the shift button and 6. Above that 6 button, there is a power symbol. So you can write down this power symbol and square 2. So it means x 6 raised to 2, we will find out the square. Similarly, 20, 1 by 2. Likewise, we can use the various operators, mathematical operators. By using this Excel, we can use the curved, cut, copy, paste, hide, unhide, link. Suppose this, I want to use this cut, copy, paste. There are some numbers are there. Suppose I want to create a data of 11, 12, and then up to 20. Either I can use the fill command. select the two cells, then insert and fill. I want to fill the data. So data, this fill command is available in fill. Data fill command is available in the flash fill. Just drag it down to the 20 number. Suppose I want to copy, cut this number, cut this value of the cell. So you can right click on the cell, then right click, use the right click, right side button of the mouse. Then you can for cutting the value, you can use the Control X, and then where we want to paste. Here in the bottom side, it is asking select the destination and press enter or choose paste. So Excel is also is helping us, giving the guideline how to use the various functions. We have used the Control X, that is cut. So when you cut the any value, then we have to paste it to any location. So I want to cut the value here of this H12 cell, and I want to paste it to the H11 cell. Then only say Control V, Control C, Control X, Control V. Control X is the cut, shortcut key for the cut function. Now it has cut the value from H12 cell, and it has pasted the value along with the formatting to the J11 cell. Similarly, I want to copy this value in the J11 cell to the H12 cell. I can either use the mouse, then press on the right side of the mouse, then copy it, then select the H12 cell, right click the mouse button, click the right side mouse button, and then you can either use the paste button, paste it directly, or if you directly paste it, it will also paste the formatting. Likewise, suppose I want to only paste the number, it will directly paste the values. I want to paste the formulas, it will directly paste the formulas only. I want to take the transpose of this one, I can use it. And how to use this transpose? Suppose select all the numbers, copy it. I want to transpose it from this value, then select anywhere. Then right click, press on the right side mouse button, and then use the transpose function. Transpose. Now it has copied and make the transpose of all the values. All the values were in the column. Aditya said value column madhe hota, the value aata row madhe pan apan copy and paste kele. So likewise, it has taken the transpose of all the values, initial values. Suppose there are many values are there, I want to shift. हे सगळे व्हॅल्यू आपल्याला शिफ्ट करायचे एका ठिकाणीपासून दुसऱ्या ठिकाणीपासून. सो वॉट आय कॅन डू, आय कॅन सिलेक्ट ऑल द व्हॅल्यूज. यू कॅन मूव इट, सिलेक्ट द सेल्स. सो वेन आय क्लिक ऑन द बॉर्डर ऑफ दिस सेल, इट विल चेंज द साईन ऑफ द कर्सर. कर्सर साईन बघा, चेंज होते. द साईन ऑफ द कर्सर इज गोईंग टू चेंज. होल्ड द लेफ्ट साइड माउस बटन, माउस लेफ्ट साइड बटन प्रेस करून ठेवा आणि ते सेल व्हॅल्यूज फक्त मूव्ह करा. देन इट विल मूव्ह ऑल द व्हॅल्यूज टू द नेक्स्ट लोकेशन. सो दॅट इज यूज फॉर मूव्हिंग द व्हॅल्यूज. Then there are some functions, some functions are there. Like we can find out the absolute value, then aggregate value, power function as we have seen, then product. Random values we have seen in the last number. There are functions like RAND, random numbers. So RAND used to find out the to generate the numbers between 0 to 1. So for that purpose RAND function is used. RAND between the function used when we want to find out the number between any value. Then we can use the round function, round down, round up and subtotal. So we'll see all these functions. Suppose that we want to find out the absolute value. So what is the absolute value of this one? So suppose that we are having the minus 12 value. I want to find out the absolute value of this one. So there is the formula, absolute. So ABS, so what is the use of this one? So when I type the ABS function, ABS means it returns the absolute value of a number. A number without its sign. So without its sign, it will generate the absolute value of any number. So ABS, write down ABS, then open bracket, select this number, and press enter. Similarly, we can use this aggregate function. What is the use of this aggregate function? So, returns aggregate in a list or a database. So, we can find out the aggregate value. Likewise, so there are many functions available. So I want to make the summation. Either I want to make the average, then I want to count it, count A, maximum, minimum, product, standard deviation of the that population, summation. I want to what I want to do. So for that purpose, there are many options are available. So we can use the aggregate function. Suppose I want to make the summation. So click on this 9. Then it is asking that either ignore the nested subtotal and aggregate function. Ignore hidden rows and nested subtotal and aggregate function for one. This is third, fourth. Suppose I will ignore nothing. So write down 4. It is asking the array. Array means where is your database? So if you are having any database, select a database and press enter. So we have used this aggregate function to find out the summation. Summation of all these number is 97. If you select these numbers, we get the summation. So we also get the summation. Here we can find out the summation is 97. Sum of all these number is 97. So likewise, we can use the aggregate function. So power we have find out. So power can be, this function is, it is asking that we write down the power function. This returns the result of the number raised to the power. So first select any number, 8, then power 2, it should give us the 64 answer, 64. So likewise, we can use the power function. Either we can use the product or multiplication, we can also use the product function. We select a 2 or 3 number, we can get the multiplication. So likewise, we can have this. So as I have told you that to generate the random numbers, we can use the RAND function. RAND function is useful when we want to generate the number between 0 to 1. So RAND, what is the use of this RAND function? So RAND function is returns a random number greater than zero, greater than or equal to 0 and less than 1. So evenly distributed changes and on recalculation. So RAND function is used to find out, to generate the random number between 0 to 1. So when I press anywhere near to this call cell, it will give us the values, random values between 0 to 1. अपन कभी पण इथे प्रेस केलं तर इट विल गिव अस द रँडम व्हॅल्यूज एनी टाइम. अँड सेकंड फंक्शन आय हॅव टोल्ड यू आर ए एंड डी बिटवीन, सो इट विल क्रिएट द रँडम, इट रिटर्न्स अ रँडम नंबर बिटवीन द नंबर्स यू सी स्क्वेअर. सपोज आय वॉन्ट टू जनरेट द नंबर बिटवीन एनी टू व्हॅल्यूज, बॉटम नंबर इज 20 अँड टॉप नंबर इज सपोज 53. And then press enter. So it will generate, anytime it will generate the number between 20 and 53. So how these numbers are generated? Normally it is the system is using the clock. Clock of this means Excel is using the clock of the system. System मध्ये जो clock लावलेला असतो त्या clock चा मिनी सेकंड वापर करून रँडम नंबर्स आर जनरेटेड. मीन्स आपण ज्या ज्या वेळेस आपण इथे क्लिक करत जाऊ त्यावेळेस कोणतं मिली सेकंद आहे, म्हणजे 10:34 आलेले आणि किती मिली सेकंद झाले ते मिली सेकंडचं, तो त्यावेळेस झाल्यास ते सिस्टीममध्ये रिट्राय करतो आणि इट विल गिव्ह द रँडम नंबर. रँडम नंबर आपण कधी पण टाकले तर नेक्स्ट टाइम ते सेम राहत नाही, सो इट विल नॉट द सेम each and every time. Then suppose there are some numbers are there, I want to round it out, 100.2534, this is the number I want to find out, the round it down. So round is the function, rounds a number to a specified number of digits. Kiti digit parant aapalyala te round off karayche. So this will be useful in the second semester for the numerical method. So there can be a number having the many digits after the so you can use this function to round it off after the fraction. So suppose that this is the number, how many digits we want. Suppose I want all the 3 digits. If I write down here 1 only, then it is rounded up to the one single digit after the fraction. So likewise, this is a round function. Similarly, round down function is there. Rounds the number down towards 0. So it will try to round the number towards the 0. So this is the number. Then how many numbers digits? 2. will give us the round down function. A round up function is also there and subtotal. We can use this subtotal function. What is the subtotal of all this one? So it returns a subtotal in a list or database. So we have to make the subtotal.